Okay, hi guys. So I have never done a declutter like this before, so I'm pretty excited. I hope this angle is okay. It looks okay in the viewfinder, so we're just gonna roll with this. So today's declutter is going to be face products. So I'm going to be doing primers, concealers, foundations, and powders. Obviously, the powders are not in front of me because I have those in a separate drawer, so I will bring those out after. So just before we get started, obviously everything in here that is old will just be going in the trash, and everything else I will try to see if I can find someone to give away to, but a lot of the stuff that I will be getting rid of is simply just old, so I think we should just start. So I don't know if I should just pull out randomly or start with primers and whatnot, but I think I'll just kind of grab from the bunch and see where we end up. So I also have my soda here because I'm gonna need that, so let's crack this boy open. Yeah, now we can do some decluttering. So I'm just starting off by grabbing random things here. So the first thing that I have here is the Becca Ever Matte Poreless Priming Perfector. I haven't really played around with this too much. I have said before that I am not really like the biggest fan of primers. I don't really feel like they do anything. So I'm not sure if I will be using this a whole lot or what, but maybe I should give it another try. I do kind of want to do a video. There's like nothing left in this. Yeah, that's kind of gross. I'm actually just gonna get rid of that. But I do want to do a video where I kind of test out primers and do like a full week of primer wear tests and stuff just to see if they actually do something for me. So I've been thinking about doing that for a while. So I think I will be saving most of these primers unless there are some that I just absolutely hate. So moving on here, we have the Revlon Candid Photo Ready Concealer. I like this concealer a lot, so this is definitely going to be staying. Another concealer that I just recently bought is the Makeup Revolution one, Conceal and Define. I also really like this one, so that one is staying as well. Now we have the Maybelline Fit Me. I'm honestly not the biggest fan of these. I don't really understand hype. I don't get why so many people like these. Don't know if I want to keep this. It's so small though that I kind of do want to keep it. But I guess for the sake of decluttering, I'm going to get rid of this because I really don't need this, and I do think I have another one somewhere that I don't know where. Maybe it's in my purse. Maybe I should have gotten that. But you know what? I'm going to get rid of this because I honestly don't really like it. So maybe I will use this one instead. Let me just swatch this. So I've only used this once, and I remember thinking it was okay. I didn't love it, but I honestly don't have like a ton of concealers, so I don't feel too bad about keeping most of the ones that I do have. So I am going to keep this Wet n Wild one. Now moving into the first foundation out of the bunch, this is the Revlon Candid Photo Ready Foundation. I tried this once, I didn't really like it. It's also just way too light for me, so I am going to get rid of this. Like, this is just not my shade at all, so I'm gonna see if I have a friend that might be able to use this and hopefully be able to give this a better home, because I am not going to be using this. Next up here, we have a sample of, I think this is the new Natasha Denona foundation, if I'm not mistaken. Tried it once, wasn't a huge fan, so I'm not going to keep this little sample around because I probably will not be using it again. I also have this NYX Pro Foundation Mixer. I have tried this before in the past and I honestly wasn't a fan. I thought it changed the consistency of my foundation, and I found that I had to use way more than I wanted for my foundation to actually get lightened. So I think I'm going to part with this because I just didn't really like the way that it made my foundation perform after putting this in. So I will see if I can give this away to someone because I feel like someone else might be able to get more use out of this than me. Now here is a foundation that I absolutely love. This is not going anywhere. This is my summer shade in the Maybelline Fit Me Superstay foundation. Is this even called Fit Me? I think this is just the Maybelline Superstay. I always get confused by those, but I'll be keeping this for sure. This is one of my holy grail foundations. I absolutely love this. Next up here, I have two of the Kat Von D foundations. I don't know if I am in frame at all. There we go. So I am going to keep these because I do really, really, really like this foundation, and I don't know. I don't want to get rid of it. I'm not ready yet. So I am going to hang on to these probably for another round, and then we will see what happens. You can tell I've used quite a bit of these, and I have mine in light 46 and light 48. So yeah, these will be staying. Next up, we have the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation. I like this foundation. I can't really say that I love it. I used to like this more than I do now. I went for a while without trying this, and then when I tried it again, I was kind of like, this doesn't last as long on me as I remembered, so I don't know how much use I'll be getting out of this, but this is a good affordable foundation that I kind of want to have in my collection just so that I have a drugstore foundation, because I honestly don't have a lot of those, so I will be keeping this. I should also probably mention that I do have two more shades of the Maybelline Superstay, so I'll be keeping both of these. I do have three. Let's see, which shades do I have? I have 120, 112, and 130. So as you can see, I really like these because I have them in so many different shapes. So those will be staying. Another foundation that will for sure be staying is my Dior Forever Undercover foundation. This is one of my holy grails. I absolutely love this. I have this in two different shades and they're both pretty much empty. They're at least 70% used, I would say, both of these. So I will for sure be keeping these. Now we have a primer. This is my Farsali Unicorn Drops. If you've been around for a while, you would know that I absolutely love this. Does it do a whole lot for my skin? I'm not really sure, but it's a nice protective layer between my foundation and my skin, and it also doesn't break apart my foundation or do anything weird, which a lot of primers tend to do for me. So I really like this. I don't know if I will repurchase it when I'm out and I don't really have a whole lot left, unfortunately, but I do really, really like this. I think this is great. This one right here is a new one to my collection. This is the Revolution. Wait, this is the Makeup Revolution. I don't understand why it says Revolution in big letters and then this is Makeup Revolution underneath. Isn't Revolution a different brand? Can someone explain to me what the hell the difference between the Makeup Revolution and Revolution? I don't even know all of these brands, but they really confuse me. So this is a very dark foundation stick that I bought that I was going to use to start cream contouring, and I've been using it the past couple of days and I really like this. So this will 100% be staying in my collection. So as you can see, I'm not decluttering a whole lot. Speaking of decluttering though, this is one that I will declutter. This is the All Nighter Concealer by Urban Decay. I just don't really like this. I can't even really put the finger on what I don't like about it, but the shade is a little bit off too. It's a little bit too yellow for me, so that combined with the formula just not being perfect, I'm going to get rid of this. Something else that I will be giving away is the No Problem Primer by Touch and Soul. This one didn't really work for me. I found that my foundation just looked worse after using this. And that's kind of what happens to me with a lot of primers. So I'll definitely be giving this away to someone who's going to get some use out of this, because I feel like a lot of people like this and I think it's a good primer. It just did not work for me. So this will be going bye-bye. Here we have another Wet n Wild foundation. This is in a different shade. This is just too light for me, so I am going to pass this along because this is pretty new. So I will be giving this away to someone who will probably get some more use out of it than me. This is the sunscreen that I've been using, and I kind of just put this in here because I've been using this as my primer. This is the Unseen Sunscreen by Supergoop, and I think this is great. This actually works really nice as a primer as well, so definitely going to be keeping this one. This is my Cover FX Power Play foundation. I wouldn't say I love this foundation. I feel like it dries a little bit too quickly for me and it's kind of hard to work with, but once you get it on, it's kind of nice, but I don't think the coverage is exactly what I'm looking for. This is more of a medium coverage and I definitely prefer full coverage. So, and also if I were to prefer something that's a little bit less coverage, I would like for that to be a summer foundation and not a winter foundation, and this is not a summer foundation for me. So I will be seeing if I can give this away to someone, and I really do not want any questions of can you send it to me, because no, I will not. Alright, moving on, we have the Estee Lauder Double Wear. I love this foundation. This is great. I think I'm pretty much gone through most of this. I want to say there's maybe like 25% left in this, so I'll be keeping this for sure. This is one of my favorite foundations. I wish it wasn't so dang expensive because I don't know if I will be repurchasing this, but I really do like it, so I am going to keep this. Something else that I will be keeping are the Farsali Skin Tune Blur Primer. I like this primer. I really dislike the bottle of this. It's really, really annoying because the consistency of this primer is so thick that when you try to pump things into the little squeezy thing, it's really hard to get anything into it, and then it just makes a mess because, I don't know, I don't like the packaging, but I like the product. I just kind of keep forgetting to use it, but I will definitely be keeping this and I will use it up, and yeah, that's pretty much the end of that. Here we have a little MAC strobe cream. I don't think I've ever used this, and the main reason for that is just because I don't really like illuminating primers. I don't even know if this is a primer. I think it's a primer, right? It's not like a liquid highlight, is it? That kind of looks like a liquid highlight. Someone tell me what you're supposed to use this for. Is this for like mixing into foundations? I feel like it might be. But I guess I will keep this around because it's super small and who knows, maybe one day I will find reason to want to use this. I don't know when that will be. I don't know if it'll ever happen, but I'll keep this little baby around, why not? Something that I will not be keeping around, however, I am making a mess here. But this is a sample of the Hourglass Vanish foundation. I did not like this foundation at all. This just did not really work for me. I found it to be extremely hard to work with. I found that a lot of the things that I put on top of it, like my concealers and stuff, it just ended up looking patchy and I wasn't really able to blend it out seamlessly. And I know people say don't use a lot of this. I did not use a lot of this and I still just did not really like how it sat on my skin at all. So given that this is just a little sample, I will be getting rid of this and I don't feel bad about that at all. Now this is a tough one because this is the Natasha Denona Transfer Matte Foundation. I actually really, really like the formula of this. The color is not great, which is why I'm like, should I keep this? But I feel like I should keep this because not only was it expensive, but I can use this to mix into different foundations. You can see it's just too yellow toned for me. And I found that Natasha Denona just doesn't have a good shade range because I tried to find my match in her new foundation as well because I like this one so much. And none of her shades really matches me. And she doesn't have a lot of neutral shades, which is kind of a shame because I really would like to get this one in my shade because this is so beautiful on the skin. And I really do like this. So I can see if I can maybe mix this into another foundation so I can make this work. I have used probably like half the tube of this. This is in 25 NY Light. So it's supposed to be neutral, but it's like neutral yellow, which you can see here. It's very, very yellow, so it's just too yellow for me. But I will keep this just because I like the formula so much and I can make it work if I really want to. This is my Too Faced Born This Way concealer. I love this. This is my everyday concealer. I have been using some other ones lately though, just because I've been trying them out, but this is what I've been using almost every day, so I like this concealer a lot. Definitely going to keep it. I will say the shade range of this is also a little bit hard to find my shade in, and this one is in porcelain, and it's just a little bit too, it's not light enough that I can use it to brighten with, but it's also a little bit yellow, so I don't know if I'll be able to find a perfect match in this, but I like this formula a lot, so this will be staying in my collection for sure. Next up is one that I know a lot of people hate it, and this is the Morphe foundation. I thought this worked fine. I like this a lot, actually. This works great for my oily skin. I have mine in F1120, and this is just a good foundation. I don't really know what else to say about it. I like this. I will keep using it. It's not going to be like my favorite foundation of all time, and I know a lot of people say that it breaks them out if they use them for a certain period of time, so I kind of take breaks in between using this because I have heard that it does really clog your pores, but if I need a very long-lasting foundation, this is definitely one that I would reach for because this one does not go anywhere, so yeah, I'll be keeping this. Oh god, this thing is so old. This is a Tarte concealer. What even is this? I think this is like the old packaging, but I hated this. I thought this was so, so thick and just, I wasn't even really able to get this to blend out at all. This is their creaseless concealer, I think it's called, and this crease like a, yeah, I don't even want to say the words, but this is just, oh my god, like this texture, it's just not good. I mean, it's very full coverage, but it's so hard to blend out, and I don't like this at all, so yeah, I'll be parting with this very easily. Something else that I didn't really like, this is the Bare Minerals Bare Pro Stick Concealer. I like this for spot concealing. I hate this for under my eyes. It just does not really work for me, but it's the kind of concealer that I can see myself just like throwing in my purse if I need to just cover up a little bit, or if my lipstick needs a touch up and I need to just put on a little bit of concealer beforehand. It's also a little bit too light though, so I just don't know if I want to keep this. I don't know. I think I'll just get rid of it because I really don't like this. And I guess I will save the primers for last. So this is my NARS Radiant Longwear, Natural Radiant Longwear Foundation. I like this a lot, but the problem with this for me is that this is my summer shade and this is not a good summer foundation for me. So I've been using it for the past couple of days or so because I do have a little bit of a tan out because it's been really nice out and it's been working really well. But I am going to keep this around though because it's a great filming foundation, especially if I'm not going to be going outside or doing much that day. So I can use this in the summer if I'm going to film. But this is not one that will last more than like 6 to 8 hours on me because I am so oily. So being that it's a natural finish, that's just kind of not really my thing in the summer. So I would like to get this in my winter shade though, so I think maybe next year I will do that because the finish on this foundation is so beautiful that I definitely want to keep it around. So if you've been thinking about trying this and you have more of like a normal skin type, I would say, then you would probably really like this. You might even like it if you're oily, but just keep in mind during the summer that it might not be that long lasting, but this is a beautiful foundation. So next up, we have a couple of primers here just to finish off, and as you can see, like, all of these are samples because I never buy primers except for this one because that one was so cheap. But this is the, what is this, the Becca Backlight Priming Filter. I've tried this a few times, and I guess this is kind of like the MAC Stroke Cream. Or I guess it's supposed to be used for like the same purpose, if I can get anything out of this. Yeah, probably not, but this is kind of like the same idea, I guess. And I like this. I don't really think it did anything for me, which is how I feel about every single primer that I've ever tried. So I don't know. Like I said, I do want to do a video where I try out like 7 different primers in a whole week and then do kind of comparisons with and without primer. I think that could be kind of interesting. So for that reason, I am going to keep this because I, you know, I need some primers to test out. And since I don't really have a lot of primers, I will be making sure to use that in that video. So that will be staying. Another one that will be staying is my Wet n Wild Photo Focus. I really liked this actually when I tried it, and I felt like this is one of very few primers that I've tried that actually made my foundation last a little bit longer and just wear better. But I don't know if it broke me out or not, so that is why I'm a little bit like iffy on this. I used it like 3 days in a row, and I did find that I had a little bit of just not breakouts, but just like bumps that I don't usually have, and I don't know if this is what caused it. So I've been a little bit wary of using this more than like just one day. So I'm going to keep this and I'll be, you know, playing around with it. I like it, so don't really have any other issues with it. And for me, when I break out, it's like I never know what to blame it on because I feel like I break out all the time, and a lot of the time is hormonal, and it just depends on what time of the month it is. And even if I use the same products for like a week straight, I still might break out. So I'm just really confused by it, so I can't really blame this, and like I said, I will be keeping this, and I will definitely keep using it. Next up, I have a sample of the YSL primer. This is another one that I just feel like does nothing for me. It's nice, like it feels nice on my skin, but I don't feel like my foundation wears any differently. It doesn't make it apply any differently, but you know, it's bougie, it's nice, it feels nice on the skin, so you know, I'll keep this little thing. Next up, this is the worst primer that I've ever tried in my whole life, and this is the Peter Thomas Roth Skin to Die For. Every time I've used this, which is probably like 4 times, I don't know why I've kept trying to use this, because any foundation that I put on top of this just looks absolutely horrible. It looks so patchy, my pores look so big, and I don't even really have big pores, but this thing is just awful. I don't know how anybody could get this to work, because this is just so bad. So that will be going, and I guess that will sum up the face. Oh wait, no, we need to do the powders. One sec. Okay, so these are my powders. As you can see, I don't have a whole lot, so I will probably be keeping most of these. Let's start off with one I will not be keeping though. This is the Australis Banana Powder. I got this from my friend Prue LaRue from Australia. And this is simply just too yellow for me, and I just don't really get along with banana powders. I don't think, I don't understand the hype, I don't really feel like they do anything for me. But I've also never tried a banana powder that's really done anything positive for me. So yeah, like I said, I'll be giving this away to someone because I feel like this just doesn't really work for my skin tone, I guess. So this will be going. So I guess I will add in my Hourglass powder to this as well, even though this was in my highlighting drawer, but this is the finishing powder. And I have mine in Luminous Light. I love this. I think this is beautiful. I've gone through a mini already, which is why I got the big sized. And I use this all the time, and I will definitely be keeping this. This is one of my favorite powders of all time. I use this to buff though. I don't use this to set my face because I find that to be a little much. But this is great for just buffing all over your face when you're done with the rest of your makeup. And then it just kind of blends everything nicely in together. So I'll be keeping this. Another one that I will definitely be keeping is the Wet n Wild Photo Focus. I have been using this pretty much every day since I bought it, and I think this is great. It really blurs and it makes my skin look really nice and smooth. I do feel like though that it has a little bit of coverage, so I don't know if this is really translucent. I know it says on it that it's supposed to be translucent, but I find that this has a little bit of coverage and I really like that about it, so that will be kept for sure. So this is my Maybelline Super Safe Full Coverage Powder Foundation. I never wear powder foundations, and I use this to set my foundation with because I felt like it would go well with my Super Stay liquid foundation, but it really doesn't. It doesn't work on my skin because I found that I got oilier way quicker when I used this powder than when I used regular setting powder. So yeah, I definitely will not be keeping this because this just did not work for me, unfortunately. This would have been nice to, you know, be able to use, but I don't know. You can't win them all, I guess. Here we have my Peach Perfect powder. I love this powder. I think this is great. It smells so good. I've used a lot of this. I don't really have a lot left, so I feel like I'm making progress. That's actually quite a big dent, so I'll be keeping this. And I think I'll be keeping most of these. Now, this is my Laura Mercier little travel size, and I'm gonna have a very unpopular opinion right now because I hate this powder. I thought this made me look so cakey. It smells so bad. I don't know if it's gone off or what, but this just did not work for me, and I don't get the hype. Like, I'm usually one who really likes super mattifying powders and stuff and more on the thicker side, and so this should have been right up my alley, but it's just, I don't know, there's something about this powder that I just don't really like, so I'll be giving this to a friend that probably will like it way more than me. This is a new powder that I just got in my BoxyCharm, and this is from The Balm, I think. Yeah, this is the Anti-Shine Translucent Powder, and I haven't tried this yet, but I'm really excited to try this because this could be a great powder to just kind of chuck in my purse if I need it. I don't really use pressed powders otherwise, but this is nice for just like touching up or for just making myself a little bit less shiny and stuff if I'm out and about. So yeah, I'm really excited to try this. This is such a cute packaging too, and I like the size of this. I like how small and compact this is, so I'm excited to try this. This is a sample of the Hourglass Veil, I think this is called. Yeah, this is the Hourglass Veil powder. I've only tried this once and I really liked it, so definitely gonna be keeping that around. Something else that I will for sure be keeping is my Peach Blur powder by Too Faced. This is kind of like the same thing as the Hourglass Ambient Lighting powders. It's just a blurring, or I guess finishing powder you could call it. It's really, really nice. You really can't see it, but it just adds a really nice sheen on your face. This is getting a bit old though, so I don't know how much longer I will be keeping this, but I really like this, and yeah, it smells good. It smells like a peach, and I can't really go wrong with makeup that smells good in my opinion, so definitely gonna be keeping this. So the next one is my Revlon Photo Ready Candid Setting Powder. I like this powder a lot. I got this from Octoly together with the foundation and the concealer, and I think this is my favorite out of all of them. I've used this a lot, and I don't really have anything bad to say about it. I think this is great, actually, so definitely going to be keeping this. And if you're looking for a very cheap powder, I think you would really like this. It also has 15 grams in it, which is quite a bit of product. So yeah, I'm very happy I was able to try this out. Another one that I also got from Octoly, this is by Sorme. This is their Mineral Secret Light Reflecting Finishing Powder. I don't really understand why it's called a finishing powder, because this is definitely a setting powder, and I can't imagine using this as a finishing powder because this is a very thick powder and it really, really sets your makeup, and it's super long lasting, and I also find it to be kind of blurring. I can see this powder not being for everyone though, because like I said, it is quite a thick powder and you really need to buff it into your skin, because otherwise you might get a bit of a white cast because this is very white. So I really like this though, and yeah, I will definitely be keeping this. Now the last one here, I'm not really sure what I'm going to do about it because I obviously have hit pan on this, and this is quite old, so I will probably just get rid of this because honestly, like I said, I don't really use a lot of pressed powders, and now that I have that little one from The Balm, I will probably just start using that, so I think this is about ready to go, so I will be getting rid of this because I don't really use pressed powders a lot, so yeah, I'll be getting rid of this, and I think that will be the end of the face declutter. So let me see how many things that I ended up getting rid of. So these are the 17 items that I ended up decluttering. I don't know if you can really count the samples, but without the samples, we are at 15. So that's not too bad. I'm really happy about that. I didn't really think that I'd be getting rid of too many of my face products, so I'm glad to kind of make up a little bit more room in my drawers. That's always nice. So I was able to get rid of 15 items. Let's see how many things that I ended up keeping. Thank you. Okay, so we have 32 items here, so I basically got rid of a third of my collection, so that's pretty good. I'm really happy about that. So yeah, I guess that was some of my face declutter. I hope you enjoyed it. I think what I'm going to do next is I'll probably move into blushes and bronzers and then take it from there. I feel like highlighter should probably be a separate video because everybody likes highlighters, and then I can take some time and actually swatch a lot of them and stuff too. So I think that's what we're going to do. So thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you are looking forward to the next one. I don't know when it will be coming up. I probably won't do them all in a row. I'll probably kind of spread them out and see how it goes. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. As always, if you are new to my channel, I would love it if you would consider subscribing, and I will see you in my next one. Bye! Thank you.